we're going to address the series of solar flares, what it means, and I'm going to talk about the effect that it could have on you, the effect it could have on the planet, how it works, just really the basics. I'm not a scientist, but I did some research on this. I'm going to share it with you because there's a lot of more stuff out there that's putting fear in people, and the mind is powerful, right? We're going to talk about this right now, about the solar flares and the actual real dangers. Yep, and that's in 2024. Let's go. Welcome to Landria, Onkka on YouTube, here to help you break through fears and live an amazing life. One of my viewers said, oh, she's plugging her book. Yeah, this book is helping hundreds of people. I'm going to plug it. You want it to be the last spiritual book you ever read? I talk about the tipping point in here. This whole channel revolves around the contents in this book. Why is it so powerful? I want to take you into that space, if you choose. I want to take you into that space where you realize, holy cow, everything's possible. The mind is powerful because the essence of you is all things. It's all connected. This is science. Quantum physics, it's this much that we actually know. We're going to talk about these solar flares. I hope you'll subscribe. Hope you'll continue to support my channel. Why? Because I want to continue to give you more expansive information and let you know that you can live an amazing, incredible life, and everything that we think and do that isn't that is our choice, all right? It's all a choice, and it's all controlled here by your beliefs, your thoughts, and most of it, you guys are getting from the stuff out there, and you're looking this stuff out because it's interesting. Boy, look at those channels. They get a lot of views. Uh-huh, it's interesting stuff. I know it is. But is it real? And what are the intentions of others? Now, we talk about the hollow moon, supposedly. You know, I don't know what it is. I do believe that the moon has a direct purpose. What? I don't know. Headquarters, maybe, to oversee things. I do believe there are structures on the moon. There's a lot of evidence to that from people who have witnessed things. And I have actually seen photographs, whether they're real or not. You know, we can debate that all day. Does it really matter? You are holding the power of the universe. Now, I want to talk about these solar flares. 1859, the Carrington event. We got hit with a, I think it was an X class. Like there's different classes, G class, M class, X class. That's like an X5 is like five times an X1 blasting. We have a protective atmosphere around our planet. We're not just sitting out there. And by the way, what's that? Of course, it's planned. You know, that's not an accident. There's no chaos in the universe. So it protects us from these blasts. Well, when we get some big ones, because it hits our electromagnetic field, of course, what does it do? Well, it can take out equipment, satellites, GPS systems. It could actually, really bad one could mess with your phone. It could definitely take out the internet. Now, if we get hit with a really big one, it's just taking out the electronics. Now, here's what I want to present to you. The Carrington event in 1859, it really took out a lot of stuff, but they did not have the advanced technology in electronics that we do. So there was not as much to lose at that point, but they got hit with a major solar flare. Somebody happened to actually witness this thing. It blinded him for a moment. He went out and noticed the spots had disappeared. Boom, blasted out. Now what's happening is NASA is, and other scientists, predicting that we were going to get hit in 2025 was going to be really bad. It's actually now 2024. Now, people are saying that they are getting sick. I want you to know, it actually didn't blast out. It was very unpredictable. Blast out to the end of December, actually, New Year's Eve, right around that time. So all you people walking around saying you're feeling sick, it hadn't flared yet. We can psychologically, you know, get ourselves set up and blame all kinds of stuff. I looked this up in every way, shape, or form, and the bottom line is there's no danger to human beings unless it goes into some other kind of fireball that's beyond flares. it doesn't have that same effect. Now, it does put out radiation. That's what the issue is. And it messes, of course, with electronics, existing electronics. So, you know, planes would have to change their flight patterns to avoid this extra little blast, because they're up there in that atmosphere. You're down here. You are not. You guys are saying you're all sick. Yeah? Well, do you remember, you know, the placebo effect? People can heal themselves. This pill helped me. We are so psychologically easily led, like sheepies, okay? It's not happening. It really isn't. And some of you are going to say, oh, it is. Well, you can tell yourself anything, but guess what? You happen to have read that stuff, right? I've read nothing. I've had two people tell me about this, that, oh, we're getting sick. Because I said, you know, there's no substance to that at all. We are perfectly healthy. And the only thing that I want to ask you about right now is, what's sitting next to your bed, or in your office or whatever, and what lights are you using? And we've got mobile phones blasting out electronic impulses that are way more unhealthy, and we're sitting next to all this stuff, right? Our whole planet's loaded with this stuff, and we're worried about a solar flare that's going to blast us? No. I want to just share this with you, and that is, those solar flares are going to start blasting, they're just going to play havoc. It could potentially take out the internet for days, maybe even weeks. I don't know, but the big one really happened. Now, there's going to be more, yes. And they're really unpredictable in the timing, of course. They can't possibly really know this. But it already happened, peeps. Yeah, it already happened days ago. So, if we get hit again, you don't have to worry about this stuff. I want you to know that we are getting ourselves all worked up over these things out there, and it's all fear-based. It's fear-based. Solar flares are real. They do have an effect. They do have radiation, but not anything that's going to harm you. There is no proof that human beings have been harmed by that. I'd be more concerned about what's in your house. Yeah, the chemicals you're using, the stuff you're putting on your lawn, you know, everything. We are so messed up here when it comes to all that, right? So I want to share with you, have nothing to fear, and we're going to see some solar flares and things, and possibly take out electronics. I think it took out like shortwave radios did go out briefly for the big flare. Yeah? Did you even notice it? No, of course not. I didn't lose anything here, did you? Let's not get ourselves worked up. By the way, all those predictions for 2023, it's 2024, none of it's happened. None of it's happened. So those of you who say, give us the predictions, I'm telling you that we're going into a higher frequency. We're going into people are learning to stay away from the fear-based crap that's just made up, and nobody has the actual answers anyways. So they're deciding, I am tired of living in fear of all this stuff that I'm being told, and I'm going to make a different choice. Which means we're going to stop living in unhealthy ways. Psychologically, our belief systems, our actions, how we treat one another, what we do for a living, all of it has to change. And it's going to be a little uncomfortable for those of you who believe that that's happiness and that's how things should be. And there's no one answer. So if you say this is how things are, I'll say, yes, of course, you're right. Do you really have all the answers? I don't. Can we keep an open mind? Yeah. Do we need to? Really? I'm just focusing on the positive changes I can make. I want to help people to change their lives. Yeah, do you want to do that? You can do it right now. And if you want to keep watching that stuff out there, you can make yourself sick. I just had one of my students say she was so sick, and I said, solar flare has nothing to do. You're not sick because of solar flare. You've got a cold. You're stressed out. So let's look at exactly what's going on with our bodies. We are human beings. We will physically be affected by things. No doubt about it. We can also surpass all of that. We know some people on the planet that have done that. All right? The mind's a powerful thing. If you focus on the things that are expansive and amazing and beautiful and the positive changes you can make, you will be a part of something so massively amazing that's going on right now. Yeah? So the answer is, solar flares are not making you sick. All right? People say that they've had these and these symptoms. But did they find out about the solar flares after they were sick and they went, oh, that might be it? Or did they hear about the solar flares first and they created that? It's up to you. I'd love to hear what your thoughts are on this, but the truth is, I'm walking around perfectly fine and I don't even know about that stuff going on. I don't even know what you guys are talking about half the time because I am focused on change. You ready? You guys have seen this. DigitalExplorers.net. Give me anything you love and I will help you, show you how to create an entire business around it with multiple income streams. We need to start loving how we earn our money. It has to be a positive thing. If we want to live happy lives, you can do it. I'll help you do it. These are free videos. I've got a free masterclass that tells you why online businesses fail. It's a real easy formula. I hope you guys will subscribe. And I will discuss this if we get a flare that takes our electronics out, then we'll see how you feel. Let's see how it physically affects people, but it didn't in 1859. There was no reports of illness back then. Yeah, so why would there be now? I don't know. Psychological, let's not go there. You're whole and perfect, strong and powerful. Loving, harmonious, and happy. Blessings to you, my friend. Namaste.